I'm not exactly sure how we start.
I've never been a hostess before. Here's what happened. Here's the true story. The true story behind the scenes what happened. Leigh was having her big launch party, and I just live an hour and a half north. I sent her a tweet saying, you know, I might try and make it down for that. And then she said...
I said, I have a better idea. I have to do this event in Redondo Beach, and I would rather do it with you. Because we had never met.
No.
We mostly spent our time online talking about books and how to pack for tour, which neither of us have mastered.
And the carry-on schlepping, and do you check your luggage, and do you not check your luggage?
Yes. So we thought we could talk about packing you guys, and then that would be the way we should
give us your tips.
Yeah.
Except we're both on the tour, so kind of too late now. But for next time.
That's true.
So, yes, that's why I came down, and then Mysterious Galaxy was nice enough to call me a hostess, so I didn't feel like it.
And I'm assuming you guys know Robin's books. They're about assassin nuns. I mean, not really nuns.
They're nuns.
They're nuns, okay. fair enough. And if you don't know them, you should. They are fantastic, and they feature two of my favorite heroines. I like heroines who are not... who don't start out where they need to end up. And hers have arcs like nobody's business. So I love it.
They're very flawed.
I like flawed heroines. I like flawed heroes. I like flawed villains.
I noticed that. Yes. I started reading Chanel Mode and Siege and Storm. So first of all, I have a couple questions before I start doing my hostessing question thing. So first of all, how many of you have read the second book? Just a few, okay. And the second question is, how many of you, in addition to being avid readers, are also kind of sort of interested in writing? Just a few of you. So most of you are just really enthusiastic readers. Okay, so that just sort of helps me know where to gear the questions and how much writing process to get into and stuff.
All right. I'm ready.
You're ready. Okay.
I'm feeling like this is going to fall over.
So I'm not going to ask you that really horrible question that everybody asks me, which is your favorite character?
Because I can actually answer that.
Oh, you can?
I can, yeah.
Well, I'm going to ask you, what is your favorite character?
My favorite character is Sturmhand, who is a privateer. He's my favorite character to write.
I could have guessed that.
Yeah. but you didn't.
You don't know that.
He's in the second book. He's a privateer. I always call him my Han Solo character. But I realized he's a little more Lando Calrissian than Han Solo. you know, he likes nice clothes, he likes the finer things. I was thinking about it recently, and we were talking about writing the second book. And for me, writing the second book was much more scary than writing the first book. Nobody's watching when I wrote the first book. And the second book, I had an editor and an agent waiting for me, and a deadline,
and fans.
Well, I wrote the second book before book one came out, so I had no... Other than my mom, I had no fans. And even she was like, yeah! But I just didn't know if I could do it. It was sort of like, you know, maybe I was a one-book wonder. So I think in a way, Sturmhand kept me company. Because unlike most of the characters in my books, like, he doesn't really struggle with, like, can I do this? Can I not do this? Do I have the strength? He's like, oh yeah, I can do this. And I can do it better than everybody else can. So he's a lot of fun to write. Yeah.
I would think, especially because he's the kind of guy for whom the end justifies the means. So he is, but not quite in an unscrupulous way. Just kind of in an incredibly dedicated way.
I think he spends less time worrying about that than a lot of characters. But I think when he's confronted with it, he kind of has to take a step back. I don't think it's clear yet how much power might or might not corrupt him.
Dum dum dum.
But I'm kind of curious about who your favorite character is. Do you have one, or do you just live with that question?
It's always like asking me which is my favorite child. It's like, you know, I hope I have favorites.
I was an only child.
She can answer this question.
That's great.
And the answer I usually give is just kind of like, hokey is that pretty much the character I'm writing right now is always my favorite because I'm so immersed in their head and their world. I'm kind of falling in love with them, and or am in love with them, or I'm ready to kick them in the ass and make them do what I need them to do, depending on where I am in the book. So it's usually whoever I'm writing. Yeah. So that would be Hannah right now.
Oh, excited!
But up until then, I like writing Isabella. Isabella's a really angry character, and I don't know if you guys have noticed, but women are allowed to be angry very much in society. Our anger is kind of made to scrunch down. It was really fun writing somebody who was pissed off and angry and not afraid to act on that anger. So there might be more angry women in my future.
like, today! Yeah, that's true. We kind of do live in the culture of nice.
Yeah. Which is one of the things I think is so fascinating about Alina is I like, well, okay, I'm gonna jump. One of the things I love about the books, and I don't know if this was intentional, I don't know if when you write you have like this theme that you're going to intentionally put in there, or just kind of, you get halfway through the second draft and go, oh, damn, there's my theme. That's what I do, so I don't know what you do, though. But I love the subtext of how Alina gets more beautiful the more she uses her power, because I love that as, you know, in life, we get more beautiful the more we step into the flow of what we're supposed to be doing and find our life work. And I wondered if that was intentional or just one of those.
I wanted to create a construction that was, you know, most, usually magic is seen as this very draining thing. You know, it's like you use magic and there's like this high cost. And the small science, which is sort of like the proper kind of Grisha power in the books, is meant to be something that feeds you and makes you healthier and you live longer and you're more beautiful. And I know actually a lot of people had beef with the fact that Alina became, but it's not like Alina's features change or like she suddenly becomes stunning. She doesn't. She just becomes the best version of herself. And so I knew that the construction of the magic was going to be that way, that it would be something that made you thrive instead of something that took away from you. But I didn't know the way it was going to play out with her character. But for me, that's sort of the message at the heart of the book, is like the things that are ugliest in you or that you fear the most about yourself or that are scariest or the things that make you different are also the things that make you powerful. And that, like, when you stop worrying about, like, I think people are always like, you know, kids are so worried about belonging, and it's not so much that, like, I feel like that's actually something that adults worry about, too. It's not like all of a sudden you reach this point where you're like, I'm an adult! I know my place in the world, and I'm full of wisdom, you know, like, you squeeze me,
there's no way, writers.
Well, I don't think any like, I don't, especially authors, like, we're such, you know, bundles of anxiety and weirdness, like.
Fragility and passion, I think we mentioned earlier, didn't we?
Fragility and passion sounds so much better than anxiety and weirdness. But yeah, I think it's also not so much about wanting to belong as wanting to be loved for or seen for who you are. You know, and being able to find your tribe, like, who will embrace you for what you are, as opposed to you trying hard to be something else.
It's kind of a human conundrum. We are so desperately afraid of letting anybody see who we really are, but we so desperately want somebody to see who we really are and love us because of that.
Yeah.
But we're so busy protecting it and hiding it. It's one of the hardest things in life to do is to learn how to slowly kind of let those fall away. And I think I love that subtext running through Alina and her.